In this video, we will learn how the Tartarini Type FL pressure regulator works through this product animation. The FL is a pilot-operated regulator, so it consists of a main valve, shown here, installed in the flow line, plus a pilot above. Also depicted is a prepilot, sometimes referred to as a pilot supply regulator, which provides the pilot with a steady, reduced supply pressure, shown in orange. Some important components on the main valve are the disc, which appears to be floating but is actually stationary, held in place with supports that are not shown in this cutaway. Next, the sleeve, which will be in the current position against the disc when no flow is required, and will slide to the left when flow is needed. The FL is an axial flow regulator, meaning it has a straight-through flow design, where the flow path has few bends, increasing flow capability and reducing noise. Next is the spring pushing the sleeve to the right into the disc to provide shutoff force. Last is the diaphragm, which is attached to the sleeve. When a higher pressure is sent to the right side of the diaphragm, the sleeve will be pushed leftward, opening and allowing flow to pass downstream. Shown now is the main valve with elevated loading pressure shown in green on the right side of the diaphragm. You can see how this pressure has pushed the diaphragm to the left, which moved the sleeve away from the disc. On the pilot, the most important components are the disc, depicted here with a triangle shape, holding back orange inlet supply pressure. Spring, which can be adjusted to achieve the desired outlet pressure set point. The lower pilot diaphragm, which is watching the outlet pressure shown in blue. And lastly, the restrictor, which is a small opening that enables the main valve to close by bleeding green loading pressure downstream. Starting while the FL is in a lockup position, meaning at zero flow conditions, let's see what happens when the downstream equipment begins consuming gas. Because the regulator is not meeting the increased flow demand, the blue outlet pressure decreases. The pilot detects this decrease in outlet pressure below its set point. The pilot spring is now exerting more force downward than the outlet pressure is exerting upward, so the pilot's diaphragm and disc move downward. This small movement by the pilot allows the higher pilot supply pressure to flood into the loading pressure chamber, increasing the loading pressure high enough that it overcomes the main valve spring. This opens the main valve, supplying the increased flow demand while holding outlet pressure slightly below set point. Before we go through that motion again, notice the order of events. First, the outlet pressure changed. Second, the pilot responded to the outlet pressure change by repositioning. Third, the loading pressure responded to the pilot repositioning. And fourth, the main valve responded to the loading pressure change. It's the same order of events on every style of pilot-operated regulator, both during opening and closing. The pilot, which is the brains, sees a change in outlet pressure and makes the main valve respond. With that in mind, let's watch the animation again. The outlet pressure is decreasing below set point. The pilot notices and is now sending a pneumatic signal to the main valve that it should open because the downstream demand isn't being satisfied. Next, let's see what happens when downstream equipment stops consuming gas. First, the outlet pressure increases because the regulator is still open, exceeding the flow demand. The pilot diaphragm senses this increase in pressure above its set point. The upward force from the outlet pressure now exceeds the downward force from the spring, moving the disc upward and closed, preventing the orange pilot supply pressure from entering the green loading pressure chamber. Next, the restrictor bleeds the green loading pressure downstream. The main spring now overpowers the reduced loading pressure, closing the main valve and matching the zero downstream demand while holding outlet pressure slightly above set point at the lockup pressure. We hope that you benefited from this tutorial on the operation of the Tartarini FL pressure reducing valve. Please like this video and subscribe to our YouTube channel for more videos like this one.